Egalitarianism, of course, is from égalité, equality, a concept that was developed in the pre-French revolutionary time, very much contributed to by developments in England, for example, the levellers, the Cromwellian opposition to King Charles I, the establishment of a true bourgeois regime in the English Revolution, followed by the American Revolution, very much influenced by Enlightenment philosophers and English critics of royal hierarchies, and of course the iconic event, the French Revolution of 1789, is, I think, arguably the birth of egalitarian values, including those of comradeship, communitarian and humanitarian unity, and the idea of people liberated from all kinds of oppression. This is carried, of course, first of all in the American Revolution, which is really a war of colonial independence from the Imperium of England, but it's really the French Revolution that I think is the birth of modernity and egalitarian value, that is, the values of the Western Hemisphere, in which equality is understood as the fundamental human attribute which is defeated by any kind of hierarchical social formation. We're sitting here for a good reason, it seems to me. Behind me is, of course, the Albert Memorial. Prince Albert was the consort of Queen Victoria, Queen of England, and also the Empress of India, and we're sitting just beneath the point in which England is seen as also dominating over Europe. The other four corners of the Albert Memorial are its domination over America, over Asia, and over the Orient. So here is England, the hierarchical imperium, which also has as its center the idea of egalitarian value. Strangely, if you could put it this way, hierarchy and egalitarianism are absolutely united in the sort of force of the imperium. If you like, egalitarianism has a hierarchical, an overpowering hierarchical dimension to it, and it's sort of represented in this memorial. But egalitarianism is all about equality, but also what we concentrate on in the project are the paradoxes of egalitarianism, that it cannot be easily divorced from hierarchy, and in fact hierarchy and equality are somehow joined and in mutual paradoxical relation. So all that we are looking at is the way in which hierarchy, in a sense, is defeated in egalitarianism, and alternatively how egalitarianism value also is continually defeated by the emergence of hierarchical forces and processes.